enable Ethiopia as a program, which is to activate users in the country and to migrate content from the ground institutions and to spread weight for other open movements. My presentation, I just highlight some of the challenges in Malawi and some of the successes in Malawi, and I will also highlight the future plans we have in Malawi. One of the main hurdles in Malawi, not trying to make any excuses, is poverty. Is the top 18 of the most poor countries in the world. So, anyway, it is what it is. On Wikipedia, basically, we use two languages. This is English, which is our official language, and Chichewa, which is our other official language. But there's due to westernization maybe, or people being educated, Chichewa as a language is it's kind of looked down upon, so there isn't much content in that as compared to English. Another challenge is our packages are very, we come from oral background, so the written word, whether it's online or books, there's a bit of people are not really enthusiastic about the written word, and that's a challenge. Another challenge, following standards of education, this is from primary to secondary, even college now, unfortunately. So, a friend of mine who was working at Catholic University, one of the schools in Malawi, he tried to activate students on Wikipedia, but the quality of the work was just poor, so he just gave up the whole exercise. Okay, now I will highlight opportunities for Wikipedia. Malawi is very rich. Malawi has a rich and diverse cultures. It's probably one of the most diverse in Southern Africa, maybe next to South Africa, I believe. Malawi is also a signatory to the Convention on the Safeguarding of Intangible Cultural Heritage, the UNESCO. Also, the Convention on the Protection of the Diversity of Cultural Expressions. Malawi has enough content to enrich Wikipedia. Just have to upload the content, I suppose. I'll give you an overview of the status of Wikipedia in Malawi. It's not pretty, so. So basically, there are two featured articles on Wikipedia in Malawi. Original articles, 8 B class articles, 10 C class articles, 100 startup articles, and 203 starts. That's not a very impressive number at all. Challenges in terms of outreach programs. The first one, not really. So I would say that there are enough venues, and we can mobilize resources. We just have to maybe find the means of doing it in a country where such concepts like Wikipedia are not as common. The good news is that there's an amazing response to outreach activities. In May, I tried to organize a weekly meetup, and about 80 people responded. But unfortunately, the owners of the venue, what mutual, they had to use the venue for their annual general meeting, I think. So the event was cancelled at the last minute. But in terms of response from people are really keen, you know, to learn or to know more about Wikipedia. Another challenge is when you talk of open movement, in Malawi, mainly the most people, especially students in college, you know, the focus is on when they finish, the focus is to get a job. There's such few jobs in Malawi. So, you know, to talk of being a volunteer, to talk of, you know, giving your time, share knowledge, it can be quite challenging. Challenges in terms of access, like other countries, internet is very problematic. It's very tricky. It's also expensive, unfortunately. And the penetration into other areas, when you get out of the main cities of Atlanta or Mzuzu, the penetration is quite low. Success stories. These include an increase in active users. It's not a big number, but we're slowly getting there. The positive response from public investors, like the Michael Technique, the Department of Journalism and Media Studies. They are so keen. They asked me if I could start activating the lecturers first before I move to the. To the students. And then Chancellor College, which is our main university campus, the Department of History and English, they are also very, very keen. We're just finalizing on the logistics on how we'll go about it. The thing in Malawi is for 1 to 2 programs in universities, for example, they have to go through the proper channels. Bureaucracy is also an issue. So for me to work with the molecular technique, for example, it needs to start from the very bit of that, they have to approve, and it has to trickle down to the departments. More success stories, positive response from private colleges as well. Positive response from international schools. International schools are very keen to join, mainly because most of the kids are kids of expatriate people in Malawi, so maybe the understanding of Wikipedia and the open movement is a bit improved as compared to most local Malawians. We are also in the process of creating a user group, and so we're doing okay. People are very keen to tell the Malawian story. Malawians actually wanting to tell their own story, which is always a good thing. We've managed to get grant partners on board, and these include national archives, like I think from Kenya. They have a lot of content in their archives, so to have them on board is a very good thing. And in terms of Malawi, they have to support Malawi as well. Future plans. We plan to evolve our user group into a chapter at some point, maybe in the next two or three years, if all goes well. We also plan to create a Creative Commons chapter in Malawi, and to also collaborate with the Copyright Center of Malawi, COSOMA, to do some published programs as regards to Creative Commons, especially. Also plan to activate all major schools in Malawi, from such as 7 schools and colleges. And we plan to involve the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Science and Technology. This is a bit tricky because for them to recognize Wikipedia, it needs to go via Parliament, and that can be a long process. Thank you.
Thank you. Any more questions? Questions, comments, communications from the floor? Okay, it seems like. Yes, I know.
Just for the people that you have activated or you have engaged with, what has been the reception that you've had from people who have tried to edit on Wikipedia?
One of the challenges is using, I think the last guest was one of the, they did point out, is using code, so that that's an extra step as well. But also when we were working together, so one of the things we did was I created an article on what a very prominent lawyer in Malawi, his name is Phoya, had done. As soon as we created that article, somebody actually nominated it for deletion, even though the article was quite substantial. So that was a bit of a downer. But luckily for us, other guys, you know, stepped in and they said, look, you know what, it's actually fine, you know. It has all the sources, it has this and that. Other than that, I would say this, the response has been okay.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Chakalit.
No.
Mr.